balance formula. For healthy joints, get 3 bottles for $47.97 or 1 bottle for $22.97. Get your supply today. Visit us online at riversidetaichi.com/joint balance formula.
Hieroglyphic Visions, a digital marketing services company. We provide digital services for your company, such as flyer design, online marketing, ad placement, logo design, and more. I've been down for a while, but every now and then contact King Gaggy at 706-914-6238 or email at kinggaggy7@gmail.com. Let me bring your vision to fruition. Peace.
Greetings and welcome to the Sirius Mindz app. This is Professor Griff. Come on in, stay for a while, browse around, check out the different communities. This live app will service your intellectual, psychic, and mental needs. So come on in, join the different communities, check them out, browse around. We have a community that will service your live stream needs, whether it's lectures, performance, interviews, online classes, and study groups. We have a community that you can join where we're talking about and dealing with research, study material, hopefully a virtual library, and as I said, online classes for you to join and take part in. We have communities that if you're on social media, you have social media information and links. And of course, if you enjoy my online weekly show, WorldStar Hit Radio and Sirius Mindz, you'll be able to catch them live right here on the app. Last but not least, we have the Oculus Inner Circle. With Oculus Inner Circle, we're dealing with the occult information, metaphysical information, esoteric information in dealing with the occult. So stay on the app, join us. And by the way, you get all this for one low price per month. Subscribe, stay on the app, share it with other people, and I'll see you in a minute. This is Professor Griff for Sirius Mindz. Seriously. Peace.
Greetings. This is Professor Griff of Public Enemy, and I want to introduce to you my new book, A Warrior's Tapestry. This book is a guide of rituals and practices that you can incorporate into your daily life. It will assist you in cultivating a life of discipline and a spirit and mindset of a warrior. It lays out a physical workout plan. It teaches you how to incorporate prayer and meditation into your daily routine. It explores the differences between education, entertainment, economics, religion, spirituality, sex, war, politics. It even breaks down and gives you a vegan meal guide and herbal supplement list. In the Warrior's Tapestry, there's also a book list, a DVD list, a movie list, a music list. We incorporate all of these things so you can develop a warrior's mindset. And all this is to help cultivating positive and clear, healthy habits spiritually, physically, mentally, and emotionally. A Warrior's Tapestry is a must-have manual for the serious seeker of the warrior spirit and lifestyle. To pre-order this book, pre-order it today. It's only $20. Price includes shipping and handling. The book is available, will be available 11/11/18. That's November 11th, 2018. You can purchase it by going to paypal.me/Professor Griff Corp or log in to www.professorgriff.com. www.upliftment.me or simply call me at 678-557-2919. Get this book, A Warrior's Tapestry, now. Please download the Sirius Mindz app and listen to further guidance and instruction on not only the Warrior's Tapestry, but weekly shows from Professor Griff. Thank you very much. Revolution is not an event, it's a process. Peace.
Peace. This is Professor Griff once again, and I'm black, and I'm back here on World Star Hit Radio and Celebrity Media TV. I think I've been gone, 3 weeks, man? Wow. So, in divine name and supreme being, I want to greet all of y'all with a very positive greeting on this very critical night, which we're going to talk about that and a few things. We're going to just talk about some things so we can catch back up, all right? So, in my travels, wow. Philly, so I did the Locks Conference, and as I told you before I left, I did Portland for a week, and I sat in Portland supporting, traveling and supporting Soleil and her taking her dance intensives. Of course, y'all know before that, she had broke her toe on one foot and stepped on a nail with the other foot. So, yeah, but hey, she suffered through it and made it happen, man. So, I applaud her. Definitely for stepping up to the plate and making it happen. And then she did another dance intensive. One was yoga and one was belly dance in Oakland for a week. So I was in Oakland. I got a chance to get with my man B, my man Bryant, peace Bryant, and got with my man Davey D from Hard Knock Radio. Got with my man Davey D. And of course I hooked up with Amina. And of course me and Amina go way back. I hooked her up. We did KPOF, I believe, and we were doing the celebration. So in honor of Fela Kuti, we did a show. I did a lecture. It was a beautiful performance put on by a lot of beautiful performers. The next night, so I was there the entire week. So it was a beautiful, beautiful thing. I got a chance to hook up with some beautiful people. I did a couple of radio shows in Portland. I hooked up with my man Quaz. I was on my man Martin's show, and it was a Marvin show. Shout out to Marvin. So we had a beautiful time in Portland, and we had a beautiful time. I got a chance to meet this young, talented individual. Eco the Savage. And then I came back and had to bounce back out of town to Dallas. I went to Dallas, and of course I hooked up with my man, Brother Ben X, as y'all saw, at the invitation of Urban Intellectuals. Go to www.urbanintellectuals and go check them out. All right, so hooked up with Urban Intellectuals. Shout out to LaTanya and Urban Intellectuals. Shout out to the whole staff of Urban Intellectuals, some beautiful people over there. I ended up speaking at Pan-African Connection in Dallas with my man Ben X. Shout out to Ben X. And then I had the pleasure of hooking up with my man Damon at Sankofa. We set some things in place that's going to happen at the end of this year and definitely going to affect next year with the Sankofa Speaks lecture series. The Sankofa Speaks lecture series at Sankofa. Beautiful restaurant. There's definitely room in there to do lectures, so we decided to come up with the Sankofa Speaks, and we're going to get it and make it happen, all right? So, shout out to everybody in Portland. Shout out to everybody in Philly. A lot of people from Philly downloaded the app. You can go to the Apple Store, and you can go to Google Play and download the Sirius Mindz app. Shout out to everybody in Oakland. The numerous radio stations I was on, the lecture, the show. Shout out to Kalfani, Dr. Khalid Abdul Muhammad's son. Shout out to my man JR, the Minister of Information. Wow, just so many people I ran into in my travels. I had the opportunity and the time to sit down, and I inked an almost entire album for the last 2 weeks I've been gone. I've been working on it for a year, but that's having to do with the music and the lyrics. So I inked almost an entire album, and thanks to Miss Soleil for the support. I had time to sit still, turn the phones off, and actually ink 10 songs. The name of my project is Heavy Mental in the Revolutionary Age of Ghetto Metal. All right? And like my man said, you got to say the whole thing. Like, it's a Tribe Called Quest. You got to say the whole thing. It's the heavy mental in a revolutionary age of ghetto metal. We do ghetto metal. All right? You probably never heard of the genre of music, but it's there. We've been doing it for a minute. There's a few bands out there. While I was in Dallas, I had a chance to go on Main Street downtown at some fuzzy taco place. Shout out to the good people at Fuzzy Taco. And I met with a band called We Are Band Nerds. I know y'all think I'm playing. Go look them up right now. I'm going to give y'all a minute. We Are Band Nerds. Shout out to the Band Nerds. They got a couple of dynamic songs. Savage, Zombies. They do rap metal also. They call it rap metal. I call mine ghetto metal. Eco the Savage, I need y'all to check him out. He just does heavy rap metal, which is a different offshoot of it. But anyway, that's the genre that I'm in. It's a beautiful thing, man, because there's bands thriving all over the country in their own lane. And that's what I would advise people to do, man. Just find your lane and make it happen, all right? Shout out to all the beautiful people at Moods Music and Soul Village. Shout out to my man, Elliot, who's making big things happen. Myself and Soleil, we have a night over there with Elliot. And we're actually doing some serious artist development at Moods Music. So if you know anybody in Atlanta that wants to perform on that stage that night, November 16th, me and Soleil have a show, artist development show that we do. It's a talent showcase. Come show us what you got. If you're in Atlanta, if you want to come to Atlanta and show us what you got, all you got to do is call me. I'll send you the information, or I can send you out the flyer on how to register and the instructions on how to register. Come hit the main stage and let's see what you got. All right. It's about perfecting your craft. It's about honing and tuning and fine tuning your craft. All right. So some people just need some fine tuning on their artistry, and some of these people are very talented and can actually make it happen. All right. So, but we want to see what you have on the main stage. All right. So contact me, Professor Griff, 678-557-2919, November 16th in Atlanta, Georgia, at the Soul Village, right next door to Moods Music. It's a talent showcase. All right. Shout out to my man, Elliot, and shout out to my man, Daryl, and the organization of people that we're putting together to make sure artists get seen and heard in Atlanta, Georgia. And of course, we're gonna live stream it. So yeah, so we'll have a whole world audience at our fingertips. All right, make sure y'all download the app, because the app will definitely be in full effect that night. All right, Hadia, peace, what's good? Niece, what's happening with you? All right, so I didn't necessarily have a subject tonight, but I just wanted to talk, just to get reacquainted with the World Star Hit Radio and Celebrity Media TV studios and family once again, because there's a whole lot has changed around here. As you can see, even the background is different. Y'all can't see it, but it's critical. Yeah, but even the backdrop and behind the green screen that we're making happen, everything is different around here. So we're getting prepared and we're laying the foundation for 2019. So just to have a conversation, as y'all can see, I don't have my glasses. I made a mistake and left them in the car, and we up in a high rise somewhere in Atlanta. It'll take me too much to go through security, go to the car. And so I'm freestyling this because I can't see. All right. So tonight, there's a few things I want to talk about. One of the main things I want to talk about, while I was on my way here, of course, y'all know I have to walk through the mall in order to get up here. And it's a critical thing, man, because I ran into the Hulk
I ran into a shark. I ran into Michael Myers with the hatchet and the knife. I ran into Chucky from Halloween or whatever child's play, kids play, whatever the movie is. I ran into Batman. I ran into Superman. And all this is me walking through the mall trying to make my way up to the WorldStar headquarters up here, studio. And because it's Halloween, all right? And I did do a little bit of research. I have it in front of me, but I don't have my glasses on, so I can't read this stuff. So just from me knowing and studying the history of this evening. Now, if you're on Facebook here, if you see my title of this, is called The Sacred Evening or Sacred Eve or The Hollow Eve. All right, so let's just break a few things down and then we can dive into some of the finer points. All right, so this sacred time of year, when it comes to those of us that other people say, Christians, say that we are pagans and we worship nature. To a degree, you're absolutely right. But what I need you to do is look up the word pagan. You say it as though it's a negative term, and it's not a negative term. All right? I'm going to let y'all take a deep breath on that. There's some stuff I could read, but I done tapped my pockets a million times. I look through every pocket, and I don't have my glasses, so I can't read y'all to find the points, but we're just going to talk. Look up the word pagan. Pagan is not a negative term. They accuse those people, our people, that looked into the crystals and could be able to look into the crystal and look forward and tell aspects of your future. They said those people that were able to look at plants and identify the plants, put a mixture together and to cure ailments. They call all of those people pagans and witches and all the other derogatory terms that these Christians at the time put these titles on anybody who was one with nature, one with themselves, and was able to take care of themselves and go hand and do that, working hand in hand and being in sync with nature. So if you read the stars in order to figure out when to plant certain seeds according to the seasons, in order for you to grow a decent crop, in order for you to feed yourself and stay alive, oh, you was a witch and you was a pagan. You was evil and you was wicked. Now, these are Christians saying this, all right? So I'm sure by now y'all have looked up the word pagan, and pagan is not a negative term. All right. Whence came the whole perversion now of what was natural by nature and what was in sync and in harmony with the natural order of things? Who are these people that came along now and took things out of this natural order and put things in a book and made you read it and put a strict guideline to it? Anything that you did outside of the confines and the context of the rules that these people set up. Oh, you were wicked, hateful, you was a demon, you was a devil, you was a witch. Mind you, you remember the witch hunts? Anything you did outside the context of the rules that they set up, you was a witch and they burned you at the stake. Right? So let's look at some of the things that actually survived that. But now when you look at these things, you look at them in a very negative light. All right? Now listen, I've been doing herbal formulas and that kind of thing that Soleil has been preparing. So actually my eyesight is getting better because of... when you study the systems in the body and you find out what herb or what mixture of herb and what tonics that are out there and what livid, not diet, but for this case, dietary laws you should be living by, all right, to renew the systems, all right? So the eyesight is actually getting better, but they said everybody at the age 50 sooner or later, he's going to get eye examination, cataract surgery, or eye exams and corrective eye surgery and laser or glasses or whatever it is. But I'm at that point right now because you're looking at a 58-year-old man. Hopefully, I don't look 58. But hopefully, I don't sound 58. Hopefully, I don't walk 58 and got a beer gut like some of these cats I be seeing. You understand what I'm saying? Motor skills not working, not able to function, can't jog a mile, can't lift your body weight, can't do any of them things at the age that I'm at. But come on, we should be able to do that and then some. 58 is young. If you look at the scripture, any scripture, Holy Quran, Bible, pyramid text, coffin text, whatever, we live to be 1,000 years old. So me being 58 is absolutely nothing. I'm still a child in this. But anyway, back to my point. Some of the customs and the traditions, you seen remnants of these things. Let me just give you a couple, all right? Right now, if you're out and about, and even if you're not, you're watching TV on social media, you'll see people dressing up in costumes. I'm going to give you the history of that in a minute, but hold on. Let's take the spider's web, which is harmless, okay? If you see that spider web today, actually, the witches of old never used to take down the spider webs growing in the house because the spider web served a medicinal purpose. I know y'all looking at me like, man, you crazy. Sit tight for a second. Hold on. Give me a second. The witches, our people, not a bad term. You need to start unlearning some of the things that racism, white supremacy taught you. And we need to start learning and going back to nature and back to the origin of some of these things so we can finally get it right. Okay? So let me finish and get to the point real quick. So the spider web, we used to let them grow simply because the witch took the spider web, rolled it around in her fingers and put it on open cuts and open wounds because the spider web actually heals the wound. So they took the spider web, something in the spider web that's a healing ingredient, and they put it on the wound and wrap it and let it sit and the wound heals. Now this is the spider web, all right? The whole idea of the black cat, the whole idea of Sekhmet, the whole idea of the study in ancient Kemet of not the praising and the worship, but the revering of the black cat, because the black cat had prominence in certain aspects of the society in ancient Kemet, now Egypt. But we need to study that in order to understand the concept of it, so when we look at the black cat today, we won't follow the thinking of white supremacist and the thinking of the race of racism, white supremacy, and what the black cat means in terms of what it means for us. But in racism, white supremacy to them, I think the saying goes, you never let a black cat cross your path, or that's 7 years bad luck or something crazy. Crazy. Really crazy. So the whole idea of the black cat, the whole idea of the spider web, the whole idea of how and why they picture witches flying on brooms and all this kind of stuff. You see, there's an origin to these things, but they will never let you know the origin, because once you know the origin, it'll connect you back to who and what you are as a people and connect you back to some aspects of your history and your past. Alright, so now, even in times of slavery, we used those things that we had access to perform rituals. As we did in the old days, in the ancient of times, in the ancient of days, if some of you scriptural people are listening, in the ancient of days, and if you do read scripture and you've studied, you know what I'm talking about. That's anytime BC. Anytime BC. So you put a number there and you put BC. Some revolutionaries say BC stands for before Christ. Some high brand revolutionaries say before the cracker. I don't know, however you want to do it. Anytime BC. In the ancient of days, all right, we use certain items in certain rituals. Some of that was carried over in our genetic code. So when they enslaved us, all right, and put us in the holds of ships and brought us to America, some of those customs survived once we unlocked that genetic code that housed those particular things. Please, some of the Hebrews and the Moors and the soothsayers and the people with the lip service, chill out for a minute. I already understand some aspects about people who are already here, all right? But we're the same people. So even if you say we were in America already, where did those people come from? So chill, all right? That's another subject for another time. I'm saying to you, what is it today that we have access to that we've used in rituals when we were in bondage? The broom. So they demonized the broom? We had spells. You understand what I'm saying? So they demonized the spells. They demonized the affirmations and the reaffirmations. They demonized all of these things. Not only did they demonize it, they took it. Because they knew it had beneficial properties and healing properties, so they took the whole idea of the ritual and the spells. They use it to summon spirits and all these other entities on a demonic level. All right, we do it in ritual form to call on the spirit of the ancestors, so we might pour libation. Back to the broom. The broom we use today to probably sweep negativity out of a room as we light sage to cleanse the room, going through that ritual. All right? When we were in bondage, we had access to the broom, and since we weren't allowed to get married or to communicate with one another, all right, we used the broom in a marriage ceremony. So we laid the broom down. We went through the verbal ritual for the commitment to one another. All right. And then we jumped over the broom. So the concept of jumping the broom now means that you're getting married. But we had to put that in place in bondage, in captivity. All right. But we had to use whatever we had at our disposal, which was the broom. I could go over many objects that you're seeing today in these rituals. Being that it was this time of year, the year of the harvest. Can you hold up 1 second? I gotta get some water. And it's right over here. Hold up. Hold up. Hold up. Don't go away. Don't go away. All right, so listen, this is the year of the harvest. Now think, I'm gonna go back through the traditional, not, give me a minute, but I'm gonna go back through the traditional meaning of Halloween. All right, so listen. So this is the year of the harvest. And there's nothing wrong with us celebrating this time of year. Just not in the way that our oppressor gave us to celebrate. Because once we start dressing up in costumes and all that other kind of stuff, then you're following these people in their wickedness and their madness. All right? Because they perverted their own tradition and traditions, plural. All right? Okay. So there's nothing wrong with celebrating this time of year. We just have to get back to how we celebrated this time of year. This is the time of the harvest. This is the time to pluck up and start putting food away for the winter in certain parts of the world. This is the time for the harvest. So there's nothing wrong with seeing an abundance of pumpkins, an abundance of corn, an abundance of food, an abundance of these things, because this is when we went out and we brought the food in from the harvest. And we stored it away. All right? Natural. Because you want to survive. If you don't think it's natural, look out your window right now and you see what the bird and the squirrel are doing. They're doing something that's very natural because they feel the winter is about to come. All right? We're in the celestial movement of the stars. We're in that time that they call the fall. But the fall of what? Why do they call it the fall? What is falling? Come on, let's think. All right? About these customs and traditions and these terms. All right? We can't just stay on the surface level on branch knowledge, they call it. We got to go to the root. And then we, that's getting a thorough knowledge of self, we got to go deeper than the root. I'm going to say that again. We don't do branch knowledge. I'm saying in 2019, we're not even going to do root knowledge. We're doing seed knowledge. Simply because in order for you to get the root, you got to plant the seed. In order for you to get the branch, you got to get the root. In order to get the root, you got to get the seed. So we got to go deep and we got to get an understanding. Seed grows from under. The water source is under. This is why you get an understanding. But we don't have to stay there. We can get an overstanding. And then deeper than that, we can get an inner standing. All right? Shout out to Reverend Phil Valentine and Ashua Kwesi. All right? We can get an inner standing. Bobby E. Wright. All right? We can get an inner standing. We can get an overstanding. And we definitely have to have an understanding. All right? The sun is getting, the days are getting shorter and shorter because the sun is falling. So by the time December 21st roll around, yeah, you barely see the sun. All right, 3 days after that, we should give you some hint as to this whole Christmas stuff, which we'll talk about later. Sun dies for 3 days, comes back to life. So it gave birth to the concept of the sun worshippers. All right, the sun worshippers. Nimrod worshiped the sun. All right, so let's understand this particular concept. We're talking about a people in a land where it was rarely any sun. So when they saw the sun, they was happy as hell for the few minutes that they saw the sun every single day. So they started worshiping the sun. All right, not having an understanding, an overstanding, and an understanding the way we understood the importance of the sun. All right, they started worshiping the sun. There was sun worshippers. All right, so understand this particular dynamic now. So when you start to look at the whole concept of the Trinity, all right, it's based on sun worship. Let's do a little trick. Not a little trick, let's play a little game, especially for the Christians out there. All right, read your Bible tonight, and whatever you want to read about the Son, S-O-N, of God, Jesus, let's do, just do me a favor. Substitute the S-U-O-N of God with the S-U-N of God and see, don't it mean the same thing, or even get a deeper inner over and inner understanding of that particular scripture. Let's try that. Let's try that. Read your Bible. And wherever you see the S-O-N of God, the Son of God, substitute it with the S-U-N of God, and let's see if we don't get a deeper understanding. Any place you see Jesus' name, substitute it with the S-U-N, the physical Son of God. And then let's tackle and track down all those scriptures that talked about the Son, the S-U-N, the light of the world, the risen Savior. Now, according to the story I just told, if you're waiting for the sun to come up every day because you're in these cold climates, then you're waiting for the sun. The sun is your savior, because that's the thing that's going to keep you alive. So they became sun worshipers. So then when it came to them remixing and revamping the scripture, they wrote the Son of God in as the Savior. That is not hard to figure out. All right? It's called astrotheology. You can go on YouTube right now and put in astrotheology, or the S-O-N, which is really the S-U-N of God, and tons of information will come up. This is no secret now. At the end of 2018, if you're still having this conflict with yourself, with this Jesus character and these worshiping of these holidays with these people, I feel for you. Because with this much information out there, you truly don't need to be stuck in that trick bag, for real. You really, really don't. And I'm not bashing anyone's religion. I'm just saying to you, you're not studying the right things. All right? We got to get to Halloween in a minute. All right. So that's just what it is in a nutshell. Now, I do see the word Halloween 2018. Halloween. Right? Hollow, the halo, it depends on your accent, on how you pronounce it. Halloween. Halloween simply means sacred evening. That's it. That's it. Halloween. Halloween is an annual holiday celebrated each year on October 31st, and Halloween 2018 occurs on a Wednesday, October 31st, originated with the ancient Celtic festival of Samhain, if my bad eyes serve me correctly. Sion, is it? Sion. Okay. When people would light bonfires and wear costumes to ward off ghosts. Why were the dead, they thought, coming up out of the ground, the spirit of the dead would come revisit the living. Some of them did not, for lack of a better term, die right. And their souls would be disturbed on this night. And some of these people were stuck between both worlds, the world of the living and the world of the dead. So they roamed the earth on this evening, the hallowed evening, the sacred evening. So what these people used to do is to quote unquote try to bribe the dead by offering them treats, food, sweet things, flowers. And some of them were so scared on this evening, they would light bonfires for two reasons. In celebration, to give back to Mother Earth for giving them a good crop, in which they had to return the favor to Mother Earth and sacrifice either an animal or a human. I'm going to let you marinate on that for a minute. On this evening, which is a sacred evening, this is why the magic wands that they use in Hollywood, the magic wand that the magicians use to cast spells and to do tricks, the maestro conducts the orchestra with the wand, all have a deeper meaning because the wand was made out of the holly wood from a Hollywood tree, from a holly tree, a sacred tree, from a sacred wood. This is why they use the holly wood to cast the spells, and this is why it's the same reason why they call the place that cast the spells and the illusions and the smoke and mirrors, this is why they call it Hollywood in California. It's the Hollywood, because the Hollywood is supposed to be a magical, sacred wood that they use to make magic wands from, that the magician and the maestro use. Hollywood is the sacred wood, because this is supposed to be Halloween, a sacred evening. But ain't nothing goddamn sacred about this evening in the way that they celebrate it. Trying to ward off the demons and the devils, because the demons and the devils are caught between two worlds, and the dead are coming back to life, like in the movie Night of the Living Dead. They're coming back to take back from the living. What are they coming to take back from the living? Why do the dead want to come back and take from the living? So now the living have to put jack-o'-lanterns and pumpkins in the window and keep a candle in the window to ward off the dead. So what the living do on this evening, according to them, is dress themselves up like the dead so they can blend in with the dead, so the dead won't come back to get from the living what they want to get from the living. So the living dress up like the dead. This is why you get the custom of dressing up in costumes, because they're hiding from the dead. All right. So what they wanted to do was give back to Mother Earth. So they used to light gigantic bonfires like they do today. And they used to make sacrifices. So they would take cows and pigs and sheep and throw it into the bonfire for the sacrifice back to Mother Earth. And when they didn't have a pig or a sheep or a cow or a chicken, they used to sacrifice some goddamn family members. Excuse my language. Some family members to sacrifice. And they did. So they would find those people that broke the law. And what they would do, they would burn them at the stake. Because when you break from tradition, they thought you were breaking the law. Because if you went back to doing things natural and you didn't follow their custom, they felt that you was doing something that was against the law. They would throw your behind in the bonfire. They would burn you at the stake. So the whole idea of these customs originating in Ireland among the Irish people. Study those customs. Study the geographical location of where these customs originated, and you'll see that in most cases during these harsh times on this time of the year, the sun is not shining as it is in places like Africa and other places. So these customs originate mainly with taking from what the leprechauns, please, I know we all about to go with this, so chill. If you study who the true leprechauns are, they're the Twa people. The short, black people that were in Ireland. Now, I know some Irish people right now that just, I'm gonna just let y'all marinate on that. Look, I'm not the best knower in the world. I study like y'all study. Study Dr. Seuss's Blackout Through Whitewash. Study some of those historians, J.A. Rogers, other people, Phil Valentine, and other people. There's elders that's still walking among us that could tell you these stories and give you this history. I just don't have the research material in front of me because I can't see right now. And I'm just giving you this stuff off the top of my head. I don't want to have this in front of my face the whole night. I can't see it, but the information is there. And we shouldn't run from the information. It's there for us to study, and we can cross-reference, all right? And we can pull the truths. So we were at the leprechaun. And I mentioned the Twa. And right now, if you don't believe me, you could go on Google. You could pull up a leprechaun. And then you could pull up our brothers and sisters who they call pygmies, who are the Twa people, and you can put them side by side, same people. Now I know some of y'all are like, I don't know, but in the 6th century and back 20,000 years ago, Professor Griff, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, all right. Go look at the origin of the black people in that region, in Europe, in Russia, Ireland, Iceland, and Greenland, and yeah. So, I don't debate. I'm just saying to you, if you can give me something to better my understanding of these histories that I'm giving you, and this talk that we're having, I humbly submit me the information. My email address is seriousmindsinfo@gmail.com. My phone number is 678-557-2919. All right? I'm just saying to you, this is not a debate. Hopefully I'm not telling you anything that you don't already know about this evening. All right? But that's just a short history of it. Now, if I went on some websites, I could read some stuff to y'all. You know, Samhain, the night they call this night, and then traditions changed over the years, and they started calling November 1st All Saints Day, and the history goes deeper than that. And then they started incorporating other things into this evening that led to All Saints Day, and they started perverting it, and yeah. So yeah, so it went through some changes, but if you get back to the origin, and this is why I don't debate, because a lot of times in debates, they don't go deep enough in order to get to the crux, to the root, and to the seed of where some of these things originate. It's easy for me to start with 50 years ago, 300 years ago, when the Irish came and blah, 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 and brought the customs and traditions and Plymouth Rock and blah, 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 and the Native Americans and the, yeah. I don't know. I don't know how deep y'all want to get. I'm just giving it to you the way I know it. All right? Okay. Halloween, the sacred evening. There's customs, traditions, and rituals that we as a people and the different tribes and different cultures that we have that existed, that came up out of the interior of Africa. All right, if you have a problem with me using the term Africa, you can call it what you want to call it. That landmass that was all together at one time, you can call it Pangaea, Asia, Asia Major, Asia Minor, whatever you want to call it, whatever you're comfortable with, all right? Those customs and traditions that came up out of the interior of Africa that ended up in the African diaspora, as you, some of you Negroes with white people's education say, diaspora. You good, don't worry about it. So let's keep in mind, the traditions are coming out of the interior, all right? And wherever we are as a people, we kept some of these traditions with us. So anywhere you go and you see us, you can connect back to aspects of these traditions that we had to hide, in the culture that we were brought into or that we helped establish, all right? I hope I said that correctly. Hypothetically speaking, if black people were in America already, we already had traditions connecting back to the people that we belonged to, which were on the planet. And the planet, there was one landmass at one time. So when people say black people were already here, I say, yeah, I agree with you. But they were, the rest of our cousins and brothers and sisters, brought from Africa to America. All right? Maybe that conversation was getting a little bit too deep. And yeah, the live feed just went off. And I'm going to start it again. All right. So the traditions and the customs, all right? The traditions and the customs that was given to us that derive from customs and traditions that we've already set in motion have now become perverted. So now we have to be mindful of what's going on. I apologize to the people here on Facebook Live. I don't know what just happened. They just killed the feed. But anyway, so we have to take into account the natural occurrence of the moon cycle, the natural occurrence of a star system and star systems, because that bright and morning star that they talk about in some cases was the SUN, but in some cases was the star system and the Sirius B, but there's only certain people that can see it. Can you imagine that? A star system being out there and only certain people walking on the planet can actually see the star system. So that when you have a conversation with the average person and the average person is talking about, you know, Sirius B or Sirius this or Sirius that, and you get locked out of the conversation because you don't have that deeper understanding, because you don't have the inner vision, as Stevie Wonder said, in order to see these star systems. So, yeah. So, we were in sync and we were in tune with the star system, plural. We were in sync with the moon, the phases of the moon. All right? So we were in sync, and since we were in sync, because this is our home, I'm talking about Earth that's inside of this universe that it sits in. And I'm trying to figure out a way to say this without sounding crazy. If you really took matter of fact, you could probably go to, what's the name of the place where they, it escapes me. I know I should know this, but, what's the place where they could show you the stars and the planets and the, somebody help me out here. What's the name of the place you go to see the stars through the telescopes and that kind of thing? A planetarium? Is that the word I'm looking for? It'll come to me in a minute. But if you can really look through some, either some virtual reality classes, or you can go to a planetarium and you can see just how small the Earth is in a larger scheme of things, as far as the universe is concerned, it is mind-numbing. I mean, I'm trying to figure out how can I. If you took pepper, like, you know, the pepper that you put on your food, if you took some pepper and you actually put it, some pepper on the back of your dog or your cat, and then went back and looked for the small little grain of pepper, that is how the Earth is in the universe. It is so infinitesimally small, it is ridiculous. So the whole idea of these people thinking that they are the gods of the universe.